For the vision is yet for an appointed time. But at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, it will not tarry. Behold, his soul which is lifted up is not upright in him. Yea, also because he transgresseth by wine, he is a proud man, neither keepeth at home, who enlargeth his desire as hell, and is as death, and cannot be satisfied, but gathereth unto him all nations, and heapeth unto him all people.
The biggest question, maybe in economics and politics of the coming decades, will be what to do with all these useless people. The problem is more boredom, and how, what to do with them, and how will they find some sense of meaning in life when they are basically meaningless, worthless. My best guess at present is a combination of drugs and computer games as a solution for more. It's already happening. Under different titles, different headings, you see more and more people spending more and more time or solving their inner problems with drugs and computer games, both legal drugs and illegal drugs. You look at Japan today, and Japan is maybe 20 years ahead of the world in everything, and you see all these new social phenomenon of people having relationships with virtual spouses. And you have people who never leave the house and just live through computers. I think once you're superfluous, you don't have power. Again, we are used to the age of the masses of the 19th and 20th century, but we saw all these successful, massive uprisings, revolutions, revolts. So we are used to thinking about the masses as powerful. But this is basically a 19th century and 20th century phenomenon. I don't think that the masses, even if they somehow organize themselves, stand much of a chance. We are not in Russia of 1917 or in 19th century Europe. What we are talking about now is like a second industrial revolution, but the product this time will not be textiles or machines or vehicles or even weapons. The product this time will be humans themselves. We are basically learning to produce bodies and minds. Bodies and minds are going to be, I think, the two main products of the next wave of all these changes. That is optional. Again, and if you think about it from the viewpoint of the poor, it looks terrible.
He disappointeth the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprise. He taketh the wise in their own craftiness, and the counsel of the froward is carried headlong. They meet with darkness in the daytime and grope in the noon. For the day of the Lord is near upon all the heathen. As thou hast done, it shall be done unto thee. Thy reward shall return upon thine own head. For as ye have drunk upon my holy mountain, so shall all the heathen drink continually. Yea, they shall drink, and they shall swallow down, and they shall be as though they had not been. But upon Mount Zion shall be deliverance, and there shall be holiness, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possessions. And the house of Jacob shall be a fire, and the house of Joseph a flame, and the house of Esau for stubble. And they shall kindle in them, and devour them, and there shall not be any remaining of the house of Esau, for the Lord hath spoken it.